As some of you might already know, I can be quite lazy. Therefore, I always look for the most efficient way to achieve a specific goal. This time around, it was about shoe modeling. And let me tell you, it is not as easy as it seems. Then, I found a video of an old shoemaker. They would stretch leather over a wooden mold. And that's when I realized, I need something like this in 3D. Reference images from the front or the side view are not enough. One of my favorite shoes that emerged from my study is the Legionnaire's boot, formerly called Caliga. In this video, I'll take you on a journey and show you the entire 3D modeling process. While modeling this shoe, I tried out some techniques that aren't that commonly used, but are incredibly powerful. For those of you who want an in-depth look, I've created a 19-part, 2-hour course of the entire process where you can learn a lot. Included is a base mesh of both male and female legs, so you can model your own shoes, and a handmade set of 11 alpha textures for cloth folds. All of this for my Patreon supporters. Check the link in the description. First, I imported the base mesh into my scene and gave it a material to distinguish it from my shoe. And I started with the first part of the shoe. From a simple plane, I deleted the face and began tracing the foot with its vertices. To add more vertices, I used loop cuts, but was quite conservative to set the stage for my favorite add-on, loop tools. I used loop tools' space function to evenly distribute the vertices. Just to show you how cool it is, I can split an edge into 5 parts and with one simple click on space, magic. The relax function also works wonders sometimes for shaping. Filling the soles' faces is quite straightforward. Extrude and scale inwards, then fill the center, add some loop cuts and smooth the vertices. Since I wanted a heel at the back, I used loop tool's flatten function to straighten one of the edge lines. Then I extruded everything upwards, brought the heel down and with proportional editing and a wide radius, I gave the sole a nice shape. Lastly, a subdivision modifier and some support loops to sharpen the edges and the sole was complete. For the upper part, I wanted a rather open design with 3 straps at the back for lacing, extending upwards to the knee and then back down, leaving the toes exposed. So I created a new plane. Using the shrink wrap modifier in project mode and with snap enabled, a setup similar to retopology, I began to trace the outer edge of that upper part. I made sure both sides had the same number of vertices, making it easier for me to fill in later. The outer loop's topology was vital for me, so I paid close attention to it. And what's unbeatable for this job? That's right, loop tools, space and relax function. Filling in the upper part was relatively simple. It broke down into a semicircle and 2 rectangles, so I let my cat Lilo handle it. Isn't he adorable? Then I used loop tools and smooth vertices to refine the topology. With proportional editing, I was able to generously shape the piece. This step was especially crucial as all subsequent steps depend on this shape. What I haven't mentioned yet. By using a base mesh, I was able to model shoes in a very short amount of time. Now that I'm starting to work on a character building kit, I'll be providing you with a pack of various shoes on my Patreon page. Next, I duplicated my outer loop and turned it into a standalone object. I had this idea in mind, a leather strap wrapping around the entire front, and what is better for that than curves? So I converted these vertices into a curve. With curves, you can add geometry and adjust the number of pulleys based on the resolution, which was perfect for my purpose. However, initially the curve wasn't very curvy, but by setting the spline type to Bezier and the handle type to automatic, you can see how beautiful the resulting topology is. Manually achieving this would be nearly impossible, and the best part is yet to come. I created another curve, a path, and used it as the geometry for my strap. This way I had a uniform width strap around the entire shoe, and thanks to the non-destructive workflow, I can make as many changes as I want till the end. Having many of these elements on the whole shoe, this technique will significantly ease my work. After adding a solidify modifier, I used proportional editing to adjust the tilt of the control points, finalizing the strap. I used the exact same technique for the front strap on the toes. Once our path was selected as geometry and the modifiers copied over from our other strap, not much adjustment was needed. For the back three straps, all preparations were already made, so all that was left was to create a Bezier curve and adjust the control points to wrap around the leg. During this, I realized that you can use snap with control points. You always learn something new. Once copied to the middle and to the top, they were blocked in and I could directly proceed to the next part of our boots. As a huge UFC fan, and I hope my neighbors forgive me for shouting during yesterday's fight, I thought, why not add some championship belts to the shoe? Starting with a circle, I filled it and shaped its sides to look like a belt. And while doing so, I made sure that I had a loop around the entire object and not just the circle. Once again, I used loop tools to improve my topology. I copied the center circle as a separate object and extruded it, creating a medallion-like shape. The surrounding circle was slightly raised to make the medallion look like it's fitting snugly inside. Then came the challenge of wrapping it around the shoe. Comparing it to knocking out Volkanovski in the first round, this would surely be a challenge for Islam too. Proportional editing wasn't helpful and I wanted to stay non-destructive. This was the perfect use case for a lattice. For those unfamiliar, a lattice is an object without geometry which you can use to stick geometry to. This allows you to modify the shape of an object without changing the actual mesh. You can also add modifiers to a lattice like the simple deform, which I used to bend the belt around the front of the shoe with ease, and later adjust its individual points to make my UFC belt fit perfectly. Even for major adjustments like on the bottom part, a lattice works wonders. Next, I moved onto the belt buckle. I started with a plane which I split along the X and Y axis using the Auto Mirror add-on. Quickly shaping it, I used bevel to round off the edges. And after an inward extrude, the relax function of the loop tool surprisingly gave me a beautiful shape. For additional modifications, I used solidify to give it some thickness, bevel for the edges and subdivision to smooth everything out. For the central pin, I copied an edge to maintain the same thickness and simply extruded it. Of course, this needed to be attached to the shoe. So I positioned it correctly and played with the curve of the strap until I achieved the desired placement. Using curves made this surprisingly easier compared to working with a mesh, which I'm usually used to. For the middle and upper part, I used a link duplicate, and this lets me make changes to just one object, and those changes are applied to all link duplicates. Useful in case I want to make any adjustments later. In the end, I reduced the radius of the last control point to taper the strap to a point, and in the same manner I shaped the belt loop. A plane with auto mirror, quickly shaped, using the same modifier stack, positioned correctly and adjusting the curve of the strap. Here too, I used link duplicates for the other parts. After I was satisfied with the overall shape of the shoe, it was time to finalize the single parts for UV unwrapping, meaning I had to convert all curves into a mesh and apply most of the modifiers. At this point, I transitioned from a non-destructive to a destructive workflow. I connected the front straps with their respective rear buckle straps, merging them into a single object that encompasses the entire shoe. To do this, I first had to remove all deforming modifiers, then merged the individual vertices, fixed the normals, reapplied the modifiers, and bring everything to its final shape. Generally, the goal now was to finalize the shape and remove any geometry that won't be visible later. While for some objects I could simply activate only rim and the solidify modifier, for others I had to manually delete the non-visible faces. This not only saves computational power because of fewer polygons, but also takes up less space on the UV map, allowing us to go into greater detail for the crucial parts. Finally, I applied all modifiers except for subdivision and bevel. To round it up, I added a few small details that will later be baked onto the textures. I used a cylinder to shape a small button, cut the top side and the quads and gave it a rounded form. With Shade Smooth and a subdivision modifier, it already looked promising. The goal was to attach this button in a circle on the front part. And to achieve this, I used the array modifier, and with an empty object as offset, I was able to perfectly distribute 12 buttons around 360 degrees. Once positioned, I used snap and by pressing the G key, attached it to my shoe. I also decided to place the same button around the outer strap at regular intervals. Similarly, I created a crisscross pattern from a plane, which I also distributed around the outer strap. Now for the finishing touches. All that remained was to add some folds to the leather. I first tried the cloth brush and the pose brush with cloth simulation, but it felt too extreme and uncontrolled. Ultimately, I turned to the good old alpha textures, which you can download from my Patreon page, by the way. The result was outstanding right from the first brush stroke. And with that, my caligae were complete. I hope you enjoyed the process and you were able to take away some valuable from it.